This is only a vlog, so I want to tell something what I'm working on. I showed this circuit a few days ago. It's an oscillator working in the, say, FM frequency band between, say, 80 megahertz and 110 megahertz. And the aim of this circuit is in the final stage to use it as an airband receiver. That of course gives kind of problems, so I want to make at first use this circuit at first to make an FM receiver, though the airband receiver has a detection of amplitude modulated signals, for instance Schiphol in the Netherlands. All amplitude modulated signals going from, say, 120 up to 130, that's very coarse. There are frequency tables published on the World Wide Web where you can exactly see the frequencies that are used at Schiphol, Schiphol Airport, anyway. So that's the ultimate goal. But of course, amplitude modulated detection differs a lot of frequency modulated detection. And I've searched on the World Wide Web whether it was possible to use this chip. This is more or less a classical chip that is often used as an IF amplifier. It's the TBA120, and there is also a code number. The S stands, as far as I know, that this chip has to have a coil at its output, frequency dependent, and there are other type numbers that are perhaps specially made for ceramic filters. So I studied first the complete airband and found that there are different stations, and the grid between all these different stations is, say, approximately 300 kilohertz or so. That means that the first air band transmitter, for instance the tower, has a certain frequency, and the next frequency of the tower goes, say, only an example, 500 kilohertz further in that air band. And that means to discriminate all these radio stations, all these frequencies in the air band, we need, in my opinion, a quite sharp filter. So that was the first idea. So I mix now airband AM and FM broadcast band together. Anyway, I hope that you can be able to follow that, what's happening here. Anyway, I searched at first for such a filter, 10.7 megahertz, and found on the World Wide Web that these filters have different bandwidths. Could be 300 kilohertz, could be 500 kilohertz. So that differs, and in fact I don't know what the bandwidth of this filter will be. So that's something to take in account, something to discover. That's the first thing. And I found that when I want to use this TBA, according to the datasheet in one of my datasheet books, I need a coil at the end to make it function as a radio detector. And that's why I'm searching now for a coil on 10.7 megahertz. Perhaps I'm going to make it by hand. These are all kinds of filters, IF filters. I really don't know what their frequency is. I have to test that first with an oscillator and a scope, etc., etc. And this, by the way, is not a filter. It's only a coil. This is a filter, a tank circuit, LC tank circuit. So perhaps I have to make such a 10.7 megahertz coil filter myself. I can do that, of course, with such a form. Wind a coil on it, test it, make a parallel capacitor. That's necessary. When I look at the data sheet of the TBA120, but of course I can also take such a filter apart, study whether it could be a filter in this high frequency range, say 10 megahertz, and then take some windings out of the coil, or take all the windings off and wind a new coil myself with a parallel capacitor, so that the filter is usable for 10.7 megahertz. Of course, the first experiment will be an FM radio frequency to detect frequency modulated signals in the broadcast band that's going in the Netherlands from, say, 80 megahertz up to 110 megahertz. And there are many local radio stations in the Netherlands at the moment. In fact, too many. So when you drive with your car through the roads in the Netherlands, you can receive on different locations all kinds of, say, provincial radio, FM radio broadcast with music, local news, etc., etc. So, again, the TBA, I salvaged it from, I think, a television set or so. So the first idea will be to mount this TBA here, somewhere here, as an IF amplifier for FM purposes, and then mount here somewhere at the input of that TBA the crystal filter, and at the output of the TBA the coil filter. And of course it must be made in such a way that you can tune, I can tune that filter to exactly to 10.7 megahertz. But of course, when you make such a coil filter yourself, it could be that the bandwidth of that filter doesn't match exactly with the bandwidth of the ceramic filter. And in fact, I don't know exactly the bandwidth of that ceramic filter. And that is all to do with experimental radio research. Of course, not experimental in a scientific way, but more or less in a hobby way, to find out how this all works. And my source is the National Semiconductor Handbook of 1979, where there is an exact description of the TBA 810 and also a test circuit. So perhaps that's a good idea to use the test circuit first. Anyway, so you see a lot of coils, and I hope that it's clear that when you have everything, in this case I have nothing. So all these coils salvaged through the years are working on specific frequencies or a specific frequency band. And when I want to use one of these coils in this application as an IF filter for this TBA A120, I need a coil that can be tuned to 10.7 megahertz. Well, this could be, for instance, a useful coil, and I have to test it. You can test such a coil with an oscillator that works on 10.7 megahertz. Send the oscillator signal to the coil, pick the signal up at the other side of the coil, and when I say the other side, at the same moment, I know that that's too broad. That's not a good way how to test such a coil, because every coil, every filter has a certain input impedance and an output impedance, and they must match in a certain way with the TBA 120. But on the other hand, that TBA is not very critical. So it could be that when I rewind this coil, make a coil for 10.7 megahertz, could be that the bandwidth is too big. But on the other hand, we have at the input of that IF amplifier, the TBA, that crystal filter that could be very sharp. And in fact, I don't know that. So, a lot of experiments, perhaps failures, perhaps success. I think more success than failures, anyway. And also, a good idea is to, for instance, take such a filter apart, open it and wind the coil off or make new windings. I have told that already. So you have a lot here, and exactly at the same time you have nothing. And also here, many crystals. But you have to search. I had to search for this small plastic bag with a ceramic 10.7 megahertz ceramic filters. And I took the 10.7 frequency by purpose to give to make enough distance between the oscillator and the frequency that I want to receive. So in a mixing process, you can mix up the frequency and mix down. So there must be a certain distance. So my idea is that is of course also experimental, to make the oscillator work on, say, only an example, 110 megahertz. And when I use a filter of 10.7 megahertz, we can, with the mixer, mix it in such a way that 10.7 megahertz, a lower frequency, or the received frequency, that's the right ID, matches with the oscillator, so that the output of the oscillator going to the mixer generates a difference of 10.7 megahertz. And that is then, after that, so you can do some calculations. I did that also. And I try to keep it as simple as possible to use this circuit, be it a FM receiver or an airband receiver. So that are all the considerations and first ideas about how to make a very simple superheterodyne radio with less components as possible, as stable as possible, and a circuit that everyone can make with some ID and interest in electronics. So here we have a lot and at the same time nothing, but anyway, I'm gonna make a 10.7 megahertz coil, and I hope the bandwidth will be small enough to receive in the proper way the radio stations.